Hey, what's up? John Sonmez here from SimpleProgrammer.com. Just want to give a quick shout out to one of our sponsors, Tech Academy. Tech Academy is a software development boot camp which offers online or in-person training. Their program is self-paced and offers students flexible scheduling. They also offer open enrollment, which means you can start at any time. So if you're looking for a coding boot camp, I definitely recommend checking them out. And today I am going to tell you how to be a well-paid programmer in 1 year. At least I'm going to attempt to answer that question. This is kind of a bold question to ask, kind of a little ambitious to be a well-paid programmer in 1 year. Can it be done? I don't know. Let's see here. So Mark says, hello, what should I do if I want to be good, well-paid programmer in 1 year, please? I know it is impossible to be professional with a high salary in 1 year. Is it possible to be just a good programmer with a decent salary? Let's say I have only 1 year to learn programming languages. What should I do? What is the best way to achieve this goal? About me, I'm 21 years old, 1 year free time, almost 8 hours a day, location Central Europe. Okay, so he's 21 years old, he's got a year, and he's got almost 8 hours a day of free time. So additional info, basic programming experience, PHP, Java, I will try my best and work very hard. Well, you better if you want to be a well-paid programmer in 1 year. So, okay, let's talk about what I would do strategically. What will we do here if we want to become a well-paid programmer in 1 year? Not a super professional, not super, super high salary, but well-paid in 1 year. You got 1 year, you got plenty of time. What do you do? First thing I would do is I would enroll in a coding boot camp. I know that some of you are like, well, why are you saying that? Are you promoting coding boot camps? Yeah, because I think that the best thing, like if you can find a good coding boot camp, I'm actually gonna plug my book. I've got a book called The Complete Software Developer's Career Guide. And in the first section of the book, you can sign up here for it. It launches in July, so maybe it's already out, but you're watching this. Otherwise, you'll sign up and get the chapters via email. But in the first section of this book, I talk about comparing between going to college, self-taught, and boot camp, and I lean heavily towards boot camp, and I'll tell you why, because it's the fastest way, if you have a good boot camp, to acquire knowledge. It's like immersion, right? If you're going to try to learn a language, immersion is probably the best way if you really want to do this. So if you spend like 12 weeks and you're just focused on learning a programming language and doing the actual work and actually building something and working with people, and you're spending 10, 12 hour days on that, that's going to get you like a super, like it's going to have an exponential increase in your learning and knowledge. I did this video a while back called I Can Learn Anything in 3 Months. It really pissed a lot of people off because they don't think it's possible. But I'm telling you, like immersion, like you get a 10x benefit when you put in that much effort, when you just immerse yourself. And so if you got 8 hours a day, and go to a coding bootcamp and just spend, you know, in fact, don't just spend 8 hours a day, spend 12, 14 hours a day focused for 3 months in your coding bootcamp and start with that base, okay? Next, after that, during that, I would start a blog, okay? Check out my course on how to create a blog to boost your career. Get the blog going. You've got a year, you can write a couple of articles a week to get that blog going. You might even start a YouTube channel and start doing tutorial videos, and maybe you produce like 2 to 3 videos a week. Again, I'm giving you the optimal here. You can scale this back to suit what time you have and how much you're willing to, how bad you want it, how willing you are to go for it, but I'm giving you the optimal. Okay, so I would do that. You could start a podcast, right? I've got a course on how to market yourself as a software developer. I'll plug that here. But that talks about all of these things on how to build a name, how to market yourself, and how to do that. If you've got a year worth of time, you probably want to implement a lot of this stuff and get yourself your name, your marketing out there, because that's going to be the best way to get a job and to get a well-paying job. Because if you start writing blog posts, right, if you start doing a podcast or you start doing YouTube videos, and you get your name out there and people know who you are, or they find you on a Google search, or when you go for a job interview, they find your blog and they find a lot of information on there, that's gonna be really fundamental in getting a good paying job, even though you don't have a lot of experience, because that's gonna make you seem a lot more knowledgeable, have a higher authority than what you would if you didn't have any of that stuff out there, even though you don't have as much experience. At the same time, you might even consider writing a small book and putting it on Kindle. I would probably start writing a few applications. Some mobile applications is a simple way to go, right? You've got a whole year, so you've got time to do this stuff. If you can write some simple applications and put them in the App Store, what that's gonna do is, even though you don't have experience, when you go to a job interview, you can say, hey, look, I have 5 apps in the App Store. I definitely know how to program. I can show you the source code for them. I've been selling these apps. You can also start your own company at that time that is an app development company and say that you work for them, because you do work for them, and so we'll put some experience on your resume. Trying to think if there's anything else that I would be doing. I'd be basically focusing as much of my time as possible to, and I would go deep, okay? I would specialize, pick one particular programming language, right? And you've only got 1 year, so you're not gonna be a jack of all trades, right? Specialization is important anyway. I've got a whole playlist on specialization that you can look at to get some ideas of what I mean, but essentially pick something, like maybe you pick the mean stack, or you pick some kind of framework, or maybe it's Angular, or maybe it's React Native, or React.js or whatever it is, but pick something very, very narrow that you're gonna get really deep knowledge of, something that you feel like you could be the best in the world at, okay, that you could honestly do that. So that just means that you're gonna have to slice something really, really thin. You know, there's a lot of people that are best in the world at things. Look at the Guinness Book of World Records. So it's not that high of a bar, but you gotta pick something. So narrow it down, and that's my strategy. You know, like I said, just to summarize, boot camp it. You know, become the best programmer in your boot camp by devoting more time and energy as possible. Get your name out there. Use How to Market Yourself, my course, if you want, but get your name out there from a blog, from podcast interviews, if you can, from YouTube videos, whatever that you can do to build up as much content in a year, and then go out there and build some applications, like I said, and that's going to help you as much as you possibly can, I think, in a year's worth of time. And you're going to learn along the way, right? All that stuff that you're going to be doing is going to be teaching you as you're building up your reputation as well. Oh, one last thing I would say is go to as many meetup groups as possible for programming in your area. That's gonna make a whole lot of sense, because you're gonna make a ton of connections. You're gonna be building your network. And if you do this now, if you have a year worth of time to build your network, by the time that year's up, I guarantee you it's gonna be super easy for you to get a job. All right, I hope that helps you. If it does, if you haven't subscribed already, click that subscribe button below. And I will talk to you next time. Take care.